Hey kids, I'd like to welcome you to join us as we find out about the story about Nathanael. Nathanael was actually introduced to Jesus by Philip, who was also another disciple of Jesus. We find out in this about how ever since Nathanael actually met up with Jesus, how pure-hearted he became, and how his rabbi teacher actually picked up on this. His pure-heartedness allowed him to be open and available for Jesus to use him. So are you ready to be open-hearted and available as we go through this story? All right, let's go.
Hey kids, it's time for our activity. And for today, I'm going to need Tiana and Sean to come help me out. So come on up, guys. Okay, we're going to play a game. They don't know what it is, but I do. All right, so we have two bowls with rice, and it has a little cross in it. And then it also has some marbles hidden in the rice. And they can't even see the marbles. So you're probably wondering, what on earth are we going to do with rice and marbles? I'm here to tell you. So we are going to tie Tiana and Sean's hands to their chest like this. And they're going to have little T-Rex hands. And they're going to have to take the marbles out of the rice and put it into this white ball over here. And whoever gets to finish first is the winner. Are you guys ready? Okay, let's go. On your marks, get set, go! All right, guys, let's see. Tiana, Sean, but I think Tiana finished first, actually. Sorry, Sean. All right, so I think we had a clear winner here, and it was Tiana. But guys, are you wondering why I had you leave your crosses in your bowls? So, see, the thing is, I wanted to represent to you guys that this bowl was kind of like your heart, and how you had to leave the cross in there because you had to take all the distractions out, which was represented by the marbles. But we made it into a pretty fun game, don't you think? Yeah. Kids, it's an encouragement to you guys to get rid of all the distractions and just focus on Jesus. All right. Up next is a time of praise and worship.
Take me higher than I thoughts black and white turn to color all around. All this new in the Savior I am found. See the sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white turn to color all around. All this new in the Savior I am found. This is living now.
I didn't see you there, but while I have you here, let's begin the Bible story of a woman with a wonderful heart and pure heart for Jesus. You can find all of this in Mark 12, verse 41 to 44. Let's begin! Yay! Jesus sat down near the collection box in the temple and watched as the crowds of people dropped in their money. Many rich people put in large amounts. Wow, that's a big one. I thought it would never end. Oh, look, there's somebody else that's coming in. Let's continue. Then a poor widow came and dropped in two small coins. Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I tell you the truth, this poor widow has given more than all the others who are making donations. For they gave a tiny part of their money, but she, poor as she is, has given everything she had to live on. Oh, wow, kids! Jesus wanted us to learn that he looks at our pure hearts, like the poor widow, as he looks at the attitudes of our hearts and how willing we are to love him and serve him with everything we have, like a pure heart, like the poor widow. So I hope you were all encouraged from the story as much as I was!
Hey kids, I hope you enjoyed the wonderful story about the poor widow whose heart was pure and right before God because she gave everything she had, the very best, over to God and his kingdom. And at the time, Jesus wanted to teach his disciples an important lesson about your heart being pure and open before God so you can give the very best over to him and his kingdom. Nathanael, one of Jesus' disciples who also had a pure and open heart before God, when he first met Jesus, Jesus saw that he was a man of openness and honesty, a true son of Israel. Jesus saw through Nathanael's pure heart that he was willing and open to give the very best to God and his kingdom. So my encouragement for you today, kids, is to ask God to teach you as a disciple how to give your very best over to him by showing love and honor to those around you. Maybe through something small like sharing a kind word of encouragement or praying for someone or even just showing someone that God cares for them through a drawing or a picture. Remember that God sees our hearts and our attitudes. So when we bless someone with something special to show them that God loves and cares for them, it not only blesses them, but it blesses God's kingdom and glorifies him too.
Hey kids, let today's memory verse wash over your heart. Christ is pure, and every person who has this hope in Christ should keep himself pure like Christ. 1 John 3 verse 3. Okay kids, let's pray. Lord, we just want to thank you for your goodness and your faithfulness in our lives and blessing us with your Son, Jesus Christ, who showed us the importance of having a pure heart. Thank you for working in our hearts nonstop and teaching us to have open hearts always to build your kingdom. Thank you that your Son, Jesus, has taught us the importance of walking out your plans for our lives with you, with a pure heart, in order to serve you, to serve others, and to love you so passionately, Father God. We pray this in your wonderful name. Amen.
You give life. You are love. You bring.
bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only.
So kids, I hope you enjoyed today's story. I am so encouraged by Nathaniel and his open-heartedness and how available he was to be used by Jesus. This allowed God to use him in order to bring forward the purpose of his kingdom. So today I want to encourage you to do the same. In that every place that you serve, you would ask God how more you can become available and how we can use your pure-heartedness in order to serve in every single aspect, whether it's in school, whether it's outside, or everywhere that you are. Come unto God and ask him, God, how can I be used by you? Make yourself available, and you will be absolutely amazed at the things that he will be able to do with that. We would love to hear from you. So please write to us and share any personal testimonies, what you liked about the lesson, and those beautiful drawings of the Bible story that we will show you in this lesson. Send this to our email at kids@harvest.co.za. Also check out our Harvest Kids Facebook page for any activity worksheets and downloads. Go in God's peace, joy, and love, and we will see you all next time.